So hello everyone, in this video we'll do the daily current affairs analysis of 25th October 2021. So the first topic which we'll discuss is about the National Fund to Control Drug Abuse. It is from GS paper 3 and topic is internal security related issues. So why it is in the news? The Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has recently recommended that the National Fund Against Drug to be used to implement anti-addiction programs rather than only policing services. So about the National Fund Against Drug Abuse. So it is instituted in accordance with the provisions of the Narcotics Drug Act and the Psychotropic Substances Act 1985. It has a corpus of around 23 crore rupees. So under the NDPS Act, the proceeds from the sale of any expropriated property or any grants made by any person or an institution go to the fund. So, use of the fund. The law states that the fund will be used to combat illicit drug trafficking, rehabilitate addicts and prevent drug abuse. So, World Drug Report 2021, an estimated 275 million people worldwide use drugs. More than 36 million people suffer from drug abuse disorders. The enhancement in marijuana use during the epidemic has been reported in many countries. Non-therapeutic use of some medicinal drugs has also been observed at the same time. According to the latest international estimates, about 5.5% of people between the ages of 15 and 64 used drugs at least once a year. More than 11 million people worldwide are estimated to be injecting drugs, half of them infected with hepatitis C. Opioids continue to account for the heavy disease burden associated with drug abuse. So the main reasons for drug abuse are fear acceptance, growing economic pressure, changing cultural norms, neurotic addiction and police inaction. So cases of drug abuse in India. So according to a report by the National Crime Records Bureau, Bureau's Crime in India 2020, a total of 59,806 cases were filed under the NDPS Act. So in 2019, there were 3.1 crore cannabis users and 2.1 crore opioid users in India. So the Indian government has adopted a number of policies and programs to address the problem of drug trafficking. The Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan or the India Drug Free campaign was announced on 15 August 2020 in 272 regions of the country that were found to be most vulnerable based on data from various sources. The Department of Social Justice and Empowerment has embarked on the implementation of the National Drug Reduction Program NAPDDR for 2018 to 2025. The government established the Narco Coordination Center NCOD in November 2016. The government has established a fund called the National Drug Abuse Fund to cover the costs incurred in the fight against trafficking in narcotic drugs, addiction rehabilitation and educating the public about drug abuse, etc. So from this analysis, you can cover all the questions which are asked in both the prelims and also in the mains, because we have covered the analysis component also, that why is the drug abuse increasing, what are the various government initiatives of the same, what are the various statistics related to the drug abuse both in India and worldwide. So you can handle all types of questions. So the prelims hot link topics are about the UNODC, overview of the International Financial Control Drug Assistance Program, structure of the Narco Coordination Center NCOD, National Drug Abuse Fund, about the Narcotics Control Bureau and the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Trafficking in Persons and themes this year. So the source of this news is this article from the Hindu website, thehindu.com. You can read that. So next is Mauritius removed from the grey list of FATF. It is from GS paper 2 and topic is international relations. So why it is in the news? The FATF Financial Action Task Force has removed Mauritius from its grey list. So why is Mauritius no longer under the additional FATF monitoring system? Mauritius has strengthened the effectiveness of its anti-money laundering and anti-terrorist financing programs and has addressed the related technical shortages to meet its strategic plan obligations regarding the shortcomings identified by by FATF in February 2020. Why was it listed? So for several years, there have been fears about Mauritius being the FPI's money laundering route due to its limited oversight mechanisms. Effect of this on India. The move will enable Indian non-banking firms and other financial companies to receive foreign direct investment from foreign investors in Mauritius. This could indirectly lead to higher investment in India from the island nation. So background. Mauritius was listed in the grey list of the FATF in February 2020. Following the listing, FDI imports from Mauritius dropped from Rs 57,785 crore in 2019-20 to Rs 41,661 crore in 2020-2021. So, source of this news is this article from the newindianexpress.com website. You can read that to get a better understanding about the topic. So, next is appointment of a liaison officer at the Information Fusion Center for Indian Ocean Region. It is from GS Paper 2 and topic is international relations. So why it is in the news? The Netherlands has said that it is interested in sending a liaison officer LO to the Navy's Information Fusion Center for Indian Ocean Region IFCIOR to enhance the prospects of maritime awareness and information sharing. So about the IFCIOR. IFCIOR was established in 2018 to coordinate with regional countries on maritime affairs and to act as a maritime data repository. It currently has contacts with more than 20 cooperative countries and agencies from many countries around the world. So it is located in Gurugram, India. Roles and responsibilities of a liaison officer. The liaison officer will be working directly with the Indian Armed Forces and other coordinators from the partner countries to improve awareness of maritime resources in the region. So the prelim short link topics are: what is IFCIOR, all about it, its objectives, its implementing agency, which are the various countries which are located in the Indian Ocean region, particularly the southern Indian Ocean region like the Mauritius, Madagascar, Seychelles. You have to study about the geographical location, you have to keep in mind particularly for the prelims, and also you have to study analyze the importance of the Indian Ocean region for India, that it is important from the geostrategic point of view to control the growing influence of China in the region, and also it is important because of the huge potential of economic growth in that region due to the high abundance of natural resources which are found there, which can be productively used by India along with all the major countries which are there in the Indian Ocean region in a free and transparent manner, so that all the countries can get benefit out of that, following the India's policy of SAGA, security and growth of all in the region. So in this manner you have to analyze a particular topic in various dimensions. So next is what is the Regional Maritime Information Center, RMIFC. You have to study about that. Who set up the Europe-led work on the Strait of Hormuz, discover the Persian Gulf and the Strait of Hormuz on the map and study about that, which are the surrounding countries of the Strait of Hormuz and the Persian Gulf. You have to study because it has been in news for quite some time now due to the US-Iran conflict going on. So source of this news is the Hindu. Next is about the International Snow Leopard Day. So it is from GS Paper 3 and topic is conservation related issues. So why it is in the news? October 23 is known as the International Snow Leopard Day. So background, the day began with the adoption of the Bishkek Declaration by 12 countries on the subject of conservation of leopards. So about snow leopard, its scientific name is Panthera ayunsia. Its geographical location, the snow leopards live in the mountains of Central Asia. The range extends to 12 countries: Afghanistan, Bhutan, China, India, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Mongolia, Nepal, Pakistan, Russia, Tajikistan and Uzbekistan. So the numbers, there are only 3920 and 6390 snow leopards left in the wild. So conservation status: snow leopards were considered an endangered species until 2017, but but the situation was changed to vulnerable species later in the year. So conservation efforts at the national level. According to some reports, India is home to about 450 to 500 snow leopards that can be found in the country's highest Himalayan regions. India has been conserving snow leopards and their habitats through the project Snow Leopard. India has also been part of the Global Snow Leopard and Ecosystem Protection Program GSLEP since 2013. In terms of conservation, India has identified three major areas, namely Hemis Spiti Crossing, Ladakh and Himachal Pradesh, Inanda Devi, Gangotri in Uttarakhand, and Khang Chendzonga, Tawang Crossing across Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. Snow leopard is on the list of 22 endangered species prepared by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So Secure Himalaya program, along with the Global Environment Facility GEF, the United Nations Development Program UNDP, has funded a project to conserve high-level biodiversity and reduce the dependence of local communities on the ecosystem. The project now operates in four snow leopard regions, namely Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Sikkim. So community volunteer program Himal Sanrakshak to protect snow leopards. Conservation efforts at the international level. In 2013, the Bishkek Declaration had set a goal of protecting at least 20 snow leopard ecosystems with a large population of leopards by 2020, and led to the development of the Global Snow Leopard and Ecosystem Protection Program GSLEP. Since then, October 23 each year is celebrated as the World Snow Leopard Day. So the Global Snow Leopard and the Ecosystem Protection Program GSLEP was also launched on the same day to address high level issues associated with the snow leopard conservation. So the prelims hotlink topics are IUCN status of the snow leopard conservation, about the snow leopard project, snow leopards in India, distribution centers and conservation, about the GSLEP, about the Bishkek proclamation. So source of this news is this article from the Times of India website. While you are reading about the snow leopard, you also have to study about the various other types of leopards which are there, or for that matter various other types of species which are vulnerable to India. They are particularly very important from the mains point of view. Okay, and the areas in which the snow leopard is found, like the Khang Chendzonga or Uttarakhand, you have to understand that the geographical location of those areas also, because as I have said many times, that UPSC, what it does, it picks a particular primary keyword and it searches for the direct and indirect keywords which are related to that particular topic in the last which have been in the news in the last couple of years, and it frames questions on those secondary topics which are not in the news directly. So that is why the proper analysis of the current affairs becomes very, very important. Okay, and this is the approach you should follow while studying current affairs. Okay, either be it from a newspaper or be it from any of the current affairs sources. Okay, other sources also. So next is about ambergris. So it is a prelim specific topic. So ambergris, which is used to make perfumes, is produced in the stomachs of sperm whales, where the undigested parts enter the intestines and bind together. So gradually they become a solid mass growing over many years. So when the animal sheds its weight, it floats on the seabed. So source of this news is this article from the Hindu website. You can read that to get a better understanding about the topic. So in the prelims, a question can be that ambergris, recently seen in the news or been in the news, is used has application in which of the following, and options can be production of perfumes, or next option can be the production of liquor, or the production of mosquito repellent, or the production of any other thing. Okay, the options can be quite confusing, so that is why you have to keep these very factual and minute details in mind while you are reading a particular topic which is in the news. Okay, so thanks a lot for watching the analysis video. Have a nice day.